Are you from a big family or a small family?
Yeah, I'm from a nine-piece family.
Nine-piece. How many brothers and sisters then?
Six brothers and three sisters.
Were you one of the youngest or?
I believe to be the youngest one.
Really? Okay.
Yeah.
Because some people say that with big families, if you are the youngest, it's also kind of an attention thing. To get the attention you desire, you need to be a little more extrovert and everything like that. Would you say that's true?
Yeah, that's true.
Were you, because to sing at 3 years old, you must have had a lot of self-confidence.
And I can't even believe that I sang at that age. You know, like my mother said, when she was telling me the story, she said, I was humming when I was born. When I was mentioning Ustandi Veni, just like went wow when he was born, and I thought maybe I must be the same thing as like him.
Yes, yeah. Wonderful. But now your mum, you adored her, didn't you?
I loved her.
Was she musical?
She was a pianist.
Was she a pianist?
And my father was a tap dancer.
Okay. We're in Cape Town, Kwalanga, 26 Makana Square to be exact. This is where Brenda was born, bred, buttered, spoiled, rotten. I don't know about that. But anyway, she's having an umcimbi. This is now after her album Mam Gopo was sold over 500,000 copies. So maybe she's just thanking, you know, her elders or ancestors. And there she is. There she is, just getting dressed. And this is our hello.
Thank you.
Brenda Fassie, the one and only in South Africa, Mzansi Africa, South Africa. We all know that Brenda Fassie won the best-selling album last year at F&B Summer Awards with Vulindlela. Will she make it this year with Noma Ganja?
We are now at the graveyard where Brenda's parents are buried. And I say parents because when Brenda's mother died, she asked to be buried together with the father. So Brenda will be coming here soon to talk to them, to thank them for everything they've done for her. And then soon after that, we're going back to the house to celebrate, drink, sing, and be merry. So
Shukume, Miss Bonnie, as I'm Sabin, Miss simhlophe sibe imbumba yamanyama sibele nsebenzi sicela kuni bomagiba boyemiye mbosofisho bavele bambhenzele sicela kuwe manganiso sicela kuwe mvutana sicela kuwe nzima.
Yeah, everybody at home plays.
Yeah.
And they sing. All my brothers, some of them play guitars, piano. Right. And I'm the singer. Okay. I'm the best singer there at home.
Any of your brothers and sisters sing as well as you though?
Yeah, sure.
Really?
My sister Nindi sings. Yeah. My brother Temba plays piano. My brother Kenny sang in exile.
Okay.
I did a song for him, Good Black Woman.
Treated me like a doggy. I say to policeman, you got a bad attitude. Oh, I'm no criminal. I'm a good black woman.
In your own fashion, you decided to go and sing, but you also decided to leave home, didn't you?
Yeah.
Why?
Because in Cape Town, Cape Town hasn't got opportunities like Johannesburg. Mm. And I ran away from home.
Really? Yes.
I hitchhiked, you know, in a truck.
How old were you?
I was about 13.
Really? Yes.
Yeah. Before Gibson Kenter came to. In fact, he had approached my mother. My mother was like, no, she's a bit lost. She's small, you know.
Yeah.
John Brickhill from Ipindombe.
Mm-hmm.
No, from Meropa.
Okay.
She wanted to take me to Australia. My mother said, no. Then I decided, no ways.
What was in your mind then? What were you. What?
Music.
Really?
I wanted to be a star. And Johannesburg, Soweto to me was like New York.
That's it.
And I thought, I'm going there. And I walked it to Soweto to find Gibson Kenter's place. After Gibson Kenter left Cape Town and after my mother refused for me to go to Soweto. The next thing she sent police behind to look for me, they couldn't find me. There is no place I've never stayed at in Soweto. You name them. Well, Irene and them in Orlando, there was a big shipping called Irene's. Dube, Pimville, Zola, everywhere, you know.
So, how did you meet Gibson Kenter?
Pragip. Hi, Pragip. Pragip. I met with Gibson Kenter when he came with How Long? And then.
You'd been in Joy already by then, had you?
No, not yet.
Oh, I see.
Not yet.
Yes, yeah.
I went to Gibson Kenter without my mother's yesterday.
Okay.
I went to Gibson Kenter.
Rebellious child.
Yes. I've always been like, I'm going to do what I want to do.
Yes.
And then I was in this play called Hunger Spoon. That's when everybody started recognizing me. Elliot Makaya is the first reporter to actually introduced me to the media.
Really? He spotted you, did he?
He spotted me.
Yeah.
We were in a rehearsal back yard at Gibson Kenter's place. Sometimes I feel like speaking Zulu, but it's okay.
we were
practicing in a rehearsal. I never had teeth then.
Oh,
and
really?
And he said, wow, what a big voice from this girl.
Mm.
Let's be fashionable. What a big voice, you know? And then he introduced me to the.
So did he put you in a band?
No, Bra Elliot decided he's gonna be putting this this picture in the newspaper all the time, and people started asking, who is this Kantubani? Then after Kirsten Kenner, then I left, then that's when I met Thoko Ndlozi
right.
of Joy.
Yes, yeah. Good days in Joy. Did you enjoy that?
Yeah, boo. Sitroko, thank you very much.
It was a happening band.
Annaline and Felicia, Marion, were my mothers.
Really? Yes. Yeah.
They taught me how to be.
In what way? Their style on stage.
The style on stage, confidence, which I had already been taught by Gibson, because Gibson came to taught me all deportment and ladies, you know.
Yeah. And so what kind of music were you doing with Joy? You were the lead singer.
I was standing in for Annaline.
Yes, right.
Yeah, she went for Baby.
What sort of music were you doing? Give us a little bit of...
Okay. I remember going for an audition. There we were, then Patrick van Blerk wanted this little verse. There are better days before us, and the burning bridge behind us, fire smoking. The sky is blurring, there is a woman waiting, weeping, and the young man nearly beaten, all for love. Paradise is almost closing. Down.
How I came to know Brenda was at the height of Blondie and Papa's popularity. We were like the band at the time, the best duet. And I said to the guys, we need a singer to come and front the band. And Dumisani Ngubeni, the keyboard player, he said, Blondes, I know just the right person. There's a little kid, her name is Brenda Fassi, and I think that she would just be suitable for this job. To call me on the phone, you don't come around. See me in the week.
Sometimes I'm not aware of how much of a superstar I am. So people say, because I don't monopolize on that, and I don't like to live another life, because I'm ain't a superstar, I'm just a person that's entertaining everybody that's famous and unfortunate. And sometimes people wonder when I go maybe to stock fairs and dance on top of the table, hola, tata, kazi, you know? And they wonder, they don't expect Brenda Fassi, you know, unfortunately Brenda, the person, is there. They get very surprised. And I like it. And I think that's the reason why a lot of people like me. Because I'm down to earth. I'm a chance again. Because I'm a chance. Everybody, you know, good guys, I'm into. You must see. But I don't know what makes me tick. You know? I surprise people. I blow more. Sometimes I find guys in a shop, maybe sitting there a lot. Smoking and I ask for a cigarette and eat some chance in Janjan, organ Janjan, organ Janjan, and they would laugh and eat the cheer, you know. I just like in the song called In the Miami Street. In the Miami Street, I got it through the way of people, of the way they talk. And so wait. Hey, straight, Linda, I'm petting your chair. I'm chilling my nine, I'm petting your chair. then I put up. So, sometimes people say, hey, Brenna, you mustn't write a song about me now, you know? That's how I am. I don't know how to explain this person, Shane, Brenda. I love Brenda. I love you, I love you, I love you, Brenda. I love Brenda first.
Hey, mom, kupuzi. Hey, nyana wam. Hey, we yasha. Alela mango bese. You no mona. Uba na nyana. Kunendo. Uli. Hey, mom, kupuzi.
One of those days again, the hot seat, and next to me, well, a well-known musician around the country, around Africa. Brenda Mabarr Basi! Hey, Cha! Yeah! Mabarr, life is still going on.
I think
it's going on, so what do you mean? I'm saying life is still going on. Are you still the happy Brenda Fasuina?
Yeah. I've always been happy. It's just that they haven't been happy.
Okay. And the album, how's it doing? The new one?
Was it all?
Okay.
Yeah. And I would like to say thank you very much to you. To you at home, to everybody. Everybody.
We are now nearing that period again, and all the musicians are like now watching. Song of the Year, Best Album. And you took it 2 times, if I'm not mistaken, right?
I'm about to watch much.
Right?
Because I wanted to go there with
you. Okay.
One time.
All right. And earlier on, before you said about Tola Yiso and about Toleda. These young musicians back in Ang, especially the ladies' side, do you see them as a threat or a challenge?
Me, a threat.
Okay.
Please, they don't threaten me.
All right.
Forget it. They look up to me. That I know.
All right.
But they must not forget. It's not what I call, I call.
All right.
Not about choosing this one.
Yeah.
And the bathroom CIA. But not about feet and feet.
Okay.
You understand? Because I know how to sing. I know how to make people happy. And I am very, very much of people's property.
Ka utlwa ke futhumana mo ke leng teng, ka utlwa ke tsha mo ke leng teng. Pele re tswela pele, yona memeza eo, yona vuli ndlela eno, e se shapile 100,000 within 2 weeks of release. Theta Brenda Fassie ba kuthole la baza kushiya ba bayangena baya phuma yena ukhona.
I never surrender, you know? And what people think my weaknesses are what they don't expect me to do. And they think, oh, she's rude or whatever. She's not expected to do this. No way. I'm not gonna start justifying my character. My character is my character, and the way I am is the way I am, so take me the way I am. You know, if I want to do anything, I want to do anytime, anywhere, with anybody, that's nobody's business. I mean, I do anything I want to do. Not because I'm Brenda Fassie, I can't fight if somebody says futsack to me. Or maybe somebody swears at me more, you know? And then I don't react because, ooh, what are people going to say if I fight? Forget it. Mutata, no. Just now, put Brenda Fassie aside and then check you out. There are people out there who like to hoi. I'm a scam, I'm a hoi scamper. When they say, okay, what I just said, you ugly thing, you don't know how we, yeah. I don't care if you say I'm ugly, fine, so what? But the main thing is, Brenda, I'm better than you, you know, you've got a problem. Why can't I say, hey, you, whoever, you're beautiful. Nobody says that. I don't believe in dreams. I don't dream. I'm not a daydreamer. I'm not a night dreamer. I don't dream. I don't dream of things. I think of things. I plan things. I don't want to lie. I don't dreaming to me. I can't tell you of any dream. I've never dreamt that I'll become what I am today. I've always believed that one day I'll be what I am today. You know, and still I'm not yet satisfied of who I am today. Only in South Africa they know me. I want to explore. I want to go out there and be known, you know, by everybody.
Got my brr in the house. Sis, well, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
You look absolutely stunning.
Thank you.
You look very pretty.
I'm 10 to 1.
Ah, yadala. You've got a new song out. Which is very nice. I think it says a lot about your personality. It says a lot about who you are. Where did you get the inspiration from?
From God. You know, God. I don't go to church, but he.
You can still speak to you even if you're at home.
God is my mentor, Pete. What about that?
Sure. Sis, bro, you know what, ne? Even when I was in primary school, I was still listening to your music. From like Khale, Kwahale. What do you think is your secret to have been around in the industry for so long?
Confidence. You try to put me down, I'm not going nowhere. What can I mean?
Definitely, definitely. And how do you deal with negative publicity and negative criticism, Mrs. Brooks?
You see, I believe the more you criticize me, the more you make me better.
But how do you deal with it? How do you deal with it when you come home and maybe somebody has said something and they've upset you or you're feeling sad?
I never get upset, you know? When I'm dead, I don't want to tell God that I misused the life that He gave me. So, mom, what is that? That's your problem. I am
going to be a woman. You live it good!
Please. Let us stay the way you are.
Yeah. Thank you! Well, this lady has been around in South African music as long as South African music has been around. Next up, we've got Mama Brenda.
Ingoma enja ibizwa Ntshwari, album yakhe ibizwa Imali. Give it up for Usis Brr.
I'm grateful to God, I'm grateful to my mother, and I'm grateful to my madrosis. Because my madrosis are always with me. But most of all, I'm grateful to the media for making me famous. Yes. And as much as I know, they're gonna break me. Don't do that again. And I would like to tell you that I'm yours. So do anything you want to do with me, it's okay.
What message do you have for your fans?
Oh, they're the best. My fans have always known the truth. I didn't have to say it. My fans voted for me. Thank you.
Great.
There's a song I want to sing for you. In fact, with the background that I'm writing at the moment, it's not that popular, but it's a song, it's in fashion. I'd like to play it. Right? Mr. Television, please follow me. Whilst we're rewinding this, I wrote, I am always looked at, right? People always look at me. But, no, why don't you close the door, rather? What? Okay. People always look at me, but I'm never looked into. People never look inside me. They don't look into Brenda and try and understand the person in her. They always look at me. Like a camera, you always look at it. But now you're looking into it, does it? Right, and it does things, shows you something, right? Good. You know if you... So I am rather not a little worried about who says what, because God gave me this life. So why not leave it? That's me, written. As long as Almighty, the one and only, can bother me, not the only person on earth, but Almighty is the only person I fear. I know how to read this. Never mind how I wrote it. I am always feeling my Lord's security. I don't get threatened easily, and my being me is the most exciting, satisfying, important main issue within the self-being. I just love being what I am, just as long as God is at all times on my side, which He is always. I don't give no da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da about no one. Whatever da-da-da-da means, right? Except for Bongani, my son, and myself, my brr, that's all. Omunye muntu, daikant, le, kuze kuyovalwa.
When days are dark, friends are few. Only now for sure I'm convinced I know. When I needed them more, a shoulder to cry on.
Bongani tells me now how much I'll be dressed now. Really? I love that.
He's a bright young man.
He's too bright. Yeah. He's gonna be a star, and he's gonna bring back all mommy's money that everybody has taken away.
But you are such an active person.
8 months. Really? And the doctor says he's gonna call police for Peter Sneyman if Peter Sneyman doesn't take me back. Because I fell on stage, and every woman in the show went,
And I suppose, in a way, he heard that music, because he's very musical, isn't he?
Yeah. He wants to be a lawyer, he wants to be, but he's more musical. My son is music.
Is he? Yes.
And I'm not going to choose for him what he wants. He must be what he wants to be.
Okay, what's the latest thing you want with Bongani?
With Bongani, yeah. Well, okay. African boy. Mm-hmm. And I love him, Mom. I asked him if he loves me so much, and he said he's gonna show me on his record. Then I was singing backing vocals. Oh, my son! Oh, I love my son. I love every son.
Give me some volume.
I've got the most intelligent son. Everybody says my son. I mean, everybody is proud of his child. But this son of mine, he's the most precious thing ever. And unfortunately, people expected my son to be uncouth, not respecting people. He surprises me. People expect me not to be responsible. I am harsh with you, right? I shout at you, right? Sometimes when you want something, sometimes I don't give you. You understand? What are you gonna be when you're old?
I haven't decided yet.
What you had decided the other day?
No, it wasn't this. Nothing like it.
What? What did you say you're gonna be?
I was going to be a lawyer.
But a lawyer is very good. In fact, I'm not going to force you to be anything. But I think to be a lawyer so that you can look after mommy's affairs, you know? So these people must stop cheating mommy. Do you understand? To be a lawyer, you must be handling my monies, my everything. You must be a lawyer. In fact, please just think about being a lawyer. You don't have to be one, but what do you really want to be?
I want to be a... I actually want to be a...
I actually, now, where have you heard that? I actually have. What do you actually want to be? Bongani's cut the television. That's it.
A singer.
He is a singer, this guy. Do you want to please, can you sing for me? Please, one.
indaba yami straight ayifuni rula kanti wena unamba bani kasafuni next
come on bye bye
indaba yami straight
ayifuni
rula
I told you
Handsome young man, you would
be. Handsome young guys, my new lover.
Brenda. 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 Very softly.
Thank you very much, guys.
This is me. Take me there where I am, my friend. Get to me and ngiyaphila. Ngiphila kayiwane and ngiyaziphilela emhlabeni. I don't know what can happen after this moment. I don't know what can happen tomorrow to me. So I do anything now. Because you never know what tomorrow brings. As far as I'm concerned, I have the hero inside.
Did you ever know that you are the hero?
I love you. Always remember that, and I need you. Always stand by me, and I'll sing for you, and I'll entertain you every time. Oh my fans, did you know how much I love you? Did you know how much I need you? Did you know how much I respect you, and how much I think of you? So important. You're the most, people make me. I haven't made myself. I respect them and I love them. But it's a one thing. Effect is I cannot live up to your expectations, unfortunately. I lead my life. So I'm not gonna live the way you want me to live. I'm not being rude, I'm not being sarcastic or funny, but please believe in me. Let me live my life. To the press, keep on writing those newspapers of yours, honey. I don't give a little bit of a worry because you're deceiving people out there. Sometimes you lie to people, sometimes you trying to make money. Propaganda is a newspaper. Journalists, it's their job, let them do their job. But they don't realize how more famous they make me, the more they write about me. Because out there, not everybody's an illiterate. People think twice.
South Africans, it is with a heavy heart and a deep sense of regret and sadness that the family of pop diva Brenda Fassie wish to advise that Brenda Fassie has passed away peacefully in her sleep early this evening.
Abantwana besikolo ilanga high apho uBrenda wayefunda khona balindele umzimba wakhe ngomculo. ukufika kwawo umzimba wothulwe ngabakhuluwa nabatshana bakhe.
I just want to say thank you for coming through for Umama. I really appreciate you, Mama. I just wanted to say hi to the president Inkosi for coming here. Inkosi.
One day, I was sitting in my room, in my house, in Orlando, downstairs, and we had an upper floor, and I just heard somebody saying, "I am a princess," running up the steps. "I am a princess." Then I asked, "Now who is that?" They say, "No, that's Brenda Fassie." I say, "No, she's right, she's a princess."
Soon and very soon, we are going to see
the king. Soon and very soon,
soon and very soon,
we are going
to see the king.
Hallelujah,
hallelujah, hallelujah, we are going to see the king.
No more dying days,
no more dying days,
no more dying days.
Brenda, you've been written about and spoken about in volumes. In the history of South African music, you will not be a paragraph, but a chapter on its own. You drove me crazy many times, in fact, sometimes to dementia. But when you smiled and those eyes lit up, it always worked. Like millions of South Africans, you charmed your way into my heart. Were you good or bad? It doesn't matter. As entertainer, you know you did it like no one else. Tomorrow, you will be laid to rest. We will never see you again on this earth, but your music will be heard and sung for a long time. To Bongani and the Fassie family, South Africa mourns with you. And by the way, on Sunday night, I looked out of my window and saw a star I'd never seen before. It was different. It was shining brighter and twinkling as a rapid pace. I went to bed and slept so well because I knew that you were well.
I can't hear the music.
Yes, Baba Kwesi. I want to say first, but I will mix like a mazetri. Mahala. Tenny, that's the hook line.
me some volume.